Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will cover heat transfer useful for all exams. I will solve GATE and IAS questions. Question is, one dimensional unsteady state heat transfer equation for a sphere with heat generation at the rate of small q can be written as. So, in sphere, unsteady state heat transfer with heat generation. For sphere and for long cylinder, both are important. So here, for sphere, 1 by r square, del by del r of r square del t, del by del x of t, and q generation by thermal conductivity, it's equal to 1 by alpha dt by change in temperature to time, with respect to time. So, from option B is your correct answer, and this one for cylinder, this is also important. GATE 2016 question, in a composite slab, the temperature at the interface T inter between two materials is equal to the average temperature at the two ends, assuming steady one dimensional heat conduction, which of the following statements is true about the respective thermal conductivities. So, different thermal conductivities K1 and K2, T inter is average of two sides. So, T1 plus T2 by 2, this is T inter. A steady heat flow, so let this is 1 and this side is 2. Q1 equal to Q2, Fourier's law of heat conduction you apply, K1 A1 equal to K2 A2 change in temperature to thickness given, area is same, so you remove this one, we have to calculate relation between their thermal conductivity. So, K1 by K2, it's equal to into L1. L1 given, it's 2B. Thickness is 2B. Then, L2 is B. So, BB you can cancel. And delta T1 is here. It's T1 minus T interface, delta T2 is interface temperature minus T2. So, interface temperature already given, it's average. Finally, if you solve this one, two cancel, then here, so you will get 2, K1 by K2 equal to 2, or K1 equal to 2K2, from option K1 equal to 2K2, D is your correct answer. GATE 98 question, the temperature variation under steady heat conduction across a composite slab of two metals with thermal conductivities K1 and K2 is shown in figure, then which one of the following statement hold true? So again, Fourier's law you apply, change in temperature to thickness, so from here it's steady heat conduction, so K is inversely proportional to temperature. So here, if TA, let this is TB, this is T interface temperature. So if you check, this is person 1 and 2. So in 1, TA minus T interface is, here I am writing TA minus T inter is greater than in section 2 So in section 1, k is less than k2 because k is inversely proportional to the change in temperature or temperature gradient. In 1, its temperature gradient is greater than in section 2, so k1 is less than k2. Answer is D. Gate 94 question. Two insulating materials of thermal conductivity K and 2K are available for lagging a pipe carrying a hot fluid. If the radial thickness of each material is same, it's in pipe carrying a hot fluid. So we have to restrict the, minimize the heat transfer rate to the outside. So here material with lower conductivity, it should be inside. And higher conductivity, it should be outside. So from option, material with lower thermal conductivity should be used for inner layer and one with higher thermal conductivity for the outer layer. B is a correct answer. Question is, two walls of same thickness and cross-sectional area have thermal conductivity in the ratio of 1:2. If the same temperature difference is maintained across the two faces of both walls, what is the ratio of heat flow? Q1 by Q2. So two walls having same thickness. Q formula is again Fourier's law. K change in temperature to thickness. Or L or X also you can write, no problem. Given K1 by K2, it's equal to 1 by 2, 1:2. Same thickness. So L1 equal to L2. And area also same. Then same temperature, temperature difference also same. So Q1 by Q2 we have to calculate. Q1 by Q2, K1 A1, K2 A2, thickness L2. So L1 equal to L2 cancel, A1 A2 cancel. Then change in temperature also same, so it's K1 by K2, and K1 by K2 given it's 1 by 2, so Q1 by Q2 it's 1 by 2. A is your correct answer. Question is, a composite wall of a furnace has two layers of equal thickness having thermal conductivity in the ratio of 3:2. What is the ratio of the temperature drop across the two layers? So K1 by K2, it's given 3:2, equal thickness, so L1 equal to L2, temperature drop across two layers, del T1 by del T2, we have to calculate. So again Fourier's law we will apply. Q will be same, Q by A, so heat flux or Q by A is same, put the values. L is thickness, so here given K1 by K2, it's 3 by 2, we have to calculate what is the ratio of temperature drop. So L1 equal to L2, you cancel it, K2 by K1, K1 by K2 is 3:2, it's 2:3. So from option A is your correct answer. Question is, a wall as shown above is made of two layers A and B. The temperature are shown in the sketch. The ratio of thermal conductivity is also given, Ka by Kb. Ratio of thickness of two layers we have to calculate. La by Lb we have to calculate. So again same. Cross section is same. तो हीट फ्लक्स इट्स के, सो सेम फॉर्मूला विल अप्लाई, क्यू बाय ए इज कॉन्स्टेंट, सो एल वन गिवेन, हियर ए ए एंड बी टर्म दे गिव, सो यू राइट इन ए बी टर्म, सो डेल टी ए हाउ मच, इट्स टी वन, इट्स इन डिग्री सेल्सियस, ओके नो प्रॉब्लम, माइनस टी टू इज 1200, सो इट्स 125, इन केस ऑफ बी इट्स 1200 माइनस 25, सो 1175 यू विल गेट, देन के बाय के बी इज टू, थिकनेस ऑफ टू लेयर्स वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट, ओके, एल ए बाय एल बी, के बी डेल्टा टी बी, के बाय के बी इट्स टू इंटू डेल्टा टी, ऑलरेडी वी कैलकुलेटेड, if you calculate this one, 25 plus 47 this is your answer, 10/47, so from option B is your correct answer. Question is, heat is conducted through a 10 cm thick wall at the rate of 30 watt per meter square. This is heat flux. When the temperature difference across the wall is 10 degrees Celsius, what is the thermal conductivity of the wall? Again, Fourier's law will apply. Q by A. Change in temperature to thickness. So Q by A given, it's 30 watt per meter square. Then we have to calculate K value into change in temperature difference is 10. Then thickness it's 10. It's in centimeters, so divide 100. 30 by 100. It's 0.3. वाट पर मीटर केल्विन, 0.3 वाट पर मीटर केल्विन, बी इज योर करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन इज, ए 0.5 मीटर थिक प्लेन वॉल हैज इट्स टू सर्फेसेस केप्ट एट 300 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड 200 डिग्री सेल्सियस, थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ द वॉल वैरीज लिनियरली, इट्स वैरीज लिनियरली, दिस इज योर की वर्ड, विथ टेम्परेचर एंड इट्स वैल्यूज at 300 degree Celsius and 200 degree Celsius, thermal conductivity is K1 and K2 given, it's varies linearly respectively, then the steady heat flux through the wall is how much? Heat flux means Q by A. Q by A we have to calculate. So first we will calculate K average, thermal conductivity average value, it's varies linearly, so it's K1 K2 by 2. K1 at 300 degree Celsius it's 25, plus at 200 degree Celsius it's 15 by 2, so 40 by 2 it's 20 watt per meter Kelvin. Then Q by A formula will apply, temperature difference by thickness. K average is 20. Temperature difference how much? 300 minus 200. Thickness is 0.5 or 5 by 10, you write. 40 into 100. So it's in kilowatt, our options are in kilowatt, so divide 1000 for kilowatt per meter square. This is heat flux. C is your correct answer. Question is, 6 kilojoule of conduction heat transfer had to take place in 10 minutes from one end to other end of a metallic cylinder of 10 cm square, cross-sectional area length 1 meter and thermal conductivity of 100 watt per meter Kelvin. What is the temperature difference between the two ends of the cylindrical bar? So T1 minus T2 we have to calculate. Temperature difference. So here Q is 6 into 10 to the power 3 by, it's in 10 minutes, so watt or joule per second. Then Q value you got. Then area given, area 10 centimeter square, so 100 square is 10 to the power 4, 1 by 10 to the power 3 also you can write, meter square term. Then length is, L is 1 meter, thermal conductivity K value given, 100 watt per meter Kelvin. Temperature difference we have to calculate. So Q into L by K. Q value how much we got? 10 watt. Then length is 1 meter. K value is 100 watt per meter Kelvin. Area is 1 by 10 to the power 3, so here you multiply 10 to the power 3, then 100 degree Celsius. B is your correct answer. Question is, a steel plate of thermal conductivity 50 watt per meter Kelvin and thickness 10 cm passes a heat flux by conduction of 25 kilowatt per meter square. If the temperature of the hot surface plate is 100 degree Celsius, then what is the temperature of cooler side of the plate? So one side T value is given, K equal to 50 watt per meter Kelvin, thickness L is 10 centimeters, so 0.1, this is in meter, heat flux Q by A, it's 25 kilowatt, so multiply 10 to the power 3 watt per meter square, then temperature of one side temperature given 100 degree Celsius, T2 value we have to calculate. Same formula we will apply. So here Q by A, put the values. K is 50, 100 minus T2, length is 0.1, so here you will get 100 minus T2, so T2 is 50 degree Celsius. C is your correct answer. In a large plate, the steady temperature distribution is as shown in the given figure. If no heat is generated in the plate, the thermal conductivity K will vary as, so here given temperature profile, temperature distribution given, So our general formula k is 1 plus alpha t. First we have to check alpha value, it's whether it's positive, negative or zero. Your alpha is positive, k equal to k o a is your correct answer. For different profile, you will get different value of alpha. Here k value is very very greater than 1. Here k value increases. Here k value decreases. And here it's constant, k equal to constant. Alpha is positive. Alpha is zero. Here alpha is negative. Or again for alpha, again one more figure I am drawing. Alpha is positive, here alpha equal to 0, alpha is negative. Alpha value and k variation you have to remember. K 0 is value of thermal conductivity at a reference temperature. Question is the temperature distribution at a certain instant of time in a concrete slab during curing is given by T equal to 3x square plus 3x plus 16, where x is in cm and T is in Kelvin. The rate of change of temperature with time is given by, assume diffusivity. So temperature distribution given. Alpha value given 0.0003. So one dimensional heat conduction will apply. Heat generation not mentioned, so you take heat generation as 0. Transient heat conduction one dimensional. We have to calculate rate of change of temperature with time. This value we have to calculate. So first six x plus 3, then again you will get 6. So put the values here. X equal to 1 by alpha, alpha is 0.0003. How much you will get? 6 into 3 by 10 to the power 4. So 18 by 10 to the power 4. D is your correct answer. Don't forget that minus sign. Here minus sign will come. A composite wall having 3 layers of thickness, so layers of thickness 0.3 meter and 0.2 meter and 0.1 meter and thermal conductivity is also given respectively, having surface area is constant. If the inner and outer temperature also given, what is the rate of heat transfer? Q value we have to calculate. We know our formula is Q equal to change in temperature by thermal resistance or equivalent thermal resistance. RTH, here 3 layers given, First, we will write the values L1 equal to 0.3, L2 equal to 0.2, L3 equal to 0.1 meter. Thermal conductivity is K1 0.6. Unit I am not writing, watt per meter Kelvin, K2. Then surface area. TA outside, TI we will write, outside 340 Kelvin. So, three layers are there. K1, K2. K3, so here TI is here, TO is here, 40 Kelvin, 340 Kelvin, L1, L2 and L3, RTH value we will calculate. Equivalent thermal resistance RTH equal to conduction only, put the values, how much you will get? 2. R equivalent thermal resistance is 2, 1840 minus 340 by RTH 2. Watt from option D is a correct answer. Composite wall of furnace has three layers of equal thickness having thermal conductivity in the ratio of 1:2, 2:4. What will be the temperature drop ratio across the three respective layers? So, data given L1 equal to L2 equal to L3. Thermal conductivity ratio. What will be the temperature drop ratio? Temperature drop ratio means this one we have to calculate. So, Q by A is constant. So, K is inversely proportional to temperature, or temperature is inversely proportional to K. One by K1, one by K2, one by one, one by two. 1 by 4, 4 into 2 into 1. B is a correct answer. Question is, what is the heat loss per hour across a wall of 4 meter high, 10 meter long and 115 mm thick if the inside wall temperature is 30 degree Celsius and outside ambient temperature is 10 degree Celsius, conductivity of brick wall is 1.15 watt per meter Kelvin. Heat transfer coefficient for inside wall is 2.5 watt per meter square Kelvin. Then that for outside wall is, so here 10 meter length, so this one 10 meter, then height 4 meter, length is, sorry, thickness is 115, this is in mm, or you can write 0.115 meter. Then temperature, this side temperature 30 degree Celsius, outside temperature 10 degree Celsius, HI value given 2.5 watt per meter square Kelvin, HO how much, 4 watt per meter square Kelvin. So heat transfer from this side to this side. So first we have to calculate RTH value. Area, first we have to calculate the area value. Area is 4 meter height, 10 meter length. So area is 40 meter square. RTH is 1 by 2.5 plus length is 0.115 by K is 1.15 plus 1 by outside heat transfer coefficient. How much you will get if you solve this one? 0.75 by 40. So Q value we have to calculate. By RTH, delta T temperature, change in temperature is 30 minus 10, it's 20 by 0.75 by 40. If you solve this one, finally you will get, multiply 100, 25 into 3, then you will get 320 into 12. Then you will get 3840, it's in kilojoule. C is your correct answer. This is the end of this part. Thank you friends, thank you for watching my video, thank you. Here in last question, your heat loss per hour, they ask. First Q value you will get in watt or joule per second term. So you multiply joule per second into 3600, you will get per hour, joule per hour, or joule you will get. Answer is C.